It's the final video until I do challenge mode shit.
Yeah. Thank God, okay. Just...
It's a boring kind of name.
Yeah. We also clipped through the Gadgetron thing.
I'll bet you.
God damn! Fucking Slim Cognito!
I swear to God, Kalon! I swear to God!
I will leave. I'll do it. No! No!
Listen, you can't tell me.
Oh, God. Damn
I'm out.
It.
I'm out. I'm going. I'm leaving.
We no, all know what Slim Cognito is.
Come back here, God damn it!
No, he laughed. This is your fault.
Anyways, the shield charger. The shield charger activated pedestrian mode, if you remember last time.
It's the game even easier, and don't use it. It's not a good weapon.
Ape, come back. Ape, it's done.
No,
Ape.
He left the room. You heard the door slamming.
I know, I did.
Just you and me now.
No.
Yeah.
Anyway, shield charger. Yep. It's certainly a way to avoid taking gratuitous amounts of damage.
Yep, it is certainly a way to make this not hard game even easier.
Yep. Also, I wanted to mention that the plot of this game is that a man who loves robots builds a thing capable of turning an entire planet of people into robots in one blast. Basically, this plot is recycled from the Sonic the Hedgehog games.
Oh, goddamn it, Kayla. But no. Atreus does not blow up half of the moon.
No, I'm talking about the Genesis games. It doesn't blow up half the moon in the Genesis games.
Listen, Atreus does not make a space theme park. And did no wrong, but just wanted to make a roller coaster.
Come on, there we go.
Sonic is a monster.
Sonic is a monster. Oh hey, we have to do this fucking shit again. Hooray.
Hooray.
I think I heard Ape come back just in time for us to talk about...
I'm only back because I'm out of beer.
Well, you're back just in time to hear us talk in burps and farts.
Yay.
That's a good line.
That is a good line. They're all pretty much good lines. I love this stuff.
Yep. Right. You talk with verbs and thoughts, you don't.
Well, I mean, your lips have to move in order to burp.
Ah, so Tyranoids only lie when they burp.
Yeah. If you're farting, you're telling the truth.
Tyranoids actually have a second mouth in place of their anus? They invented the phrase talking out of your ass.
Oh, man. This guy is really doubtful of our commitment to Dr. Nefarious because we're a squishy and not a robot.
It's like one fucking bursar and most hitman level on the Mississippi River who sees through you every goddamn time.
Alright, and then the last titanium bolt in the game, right here. You also get a trophy for collecting them all. You also get a trophy for doing all of the skill points and getting your health up to, I think, 200. Mm-hmm. And then there's also one trophy, for getting all of the weapons to max level.
Yeah, the trophy's a huge pain in the ass. Don't do them.
Yeah, no. Unless you really love the game, like I do.
You fuckhead.
Listen, as much as I love this game, it still took me, like, a year to get the effort and energy up to actually platinum the game.
Yeah, you need to max level of weapons. I'm pretty sure that's actual max level, not pre-challenge mode.
Yeah, it is actual max level.
Mm-hmm.
You have to do challenge mode several times in order to get that trophy.
That's a huge pain in the tits.
Mm-hmm.
God damn it.
I don't even remember if this is the last guy or not.
I hope it is.
I hope it is too.
But you know, Kalon, editing software. You take out all the hacker buses, but no, leave this in. This is fucking gold.
Listen, the hacker puzzles are even worse.
Yeah, you didn't give them your copy of Amoeboids Gone Wild.
We said we would give it late. We'll get it later. We'll give it to him later. Anyway, the only way to level up the shield is just to ram your face into things and then hope it doesn't go away while you're ramming your face into things.
Yeah, it's fucking annoying to level up.
It is. There are a couple weapons that are really annoying to level up, thus making that trophy an even bigger pain in the ass.
Yeah, with both shields.
Yeah.
He's back.
At least this shield is useful.
Yep, the other shield is super fucking useless in this game, except maybe kind of the arenas, but kind of.
I don't even use it in the arenas. It's just fucking useless through and through. Usually, there are a couple guys behind that door. I don't know what happened to them. They're dead. That might be something to do with, like, the fluid difficulty that these games have. Where, like, if you, depending on how good you do, the enemies that spawn in certain places and don't spawn in other places and all that.
The game thinks you suck.
Yeah, maybe. I mean, it's a fair assessment.
Yes.
I cannot wait until Arkham and prove that I am actually good at a video game.
Yeah, side note, all of the Arkham videos are spliced together from two different runs.
Yeah, but you will never know which run is which.
Hey, one run always lies, one run always tells the truth. And the practice run stabs people who ask tricky questions.
Anyway, we got the Lawrence Trophy. That's the last character trophy. All the other trophies you have to earn by relentless grinding.
Good team.
So the person who wanted me to keep the last hacker puzzle in, no, fuck
no,
you.
No, no, no.
Nope.
No.
Not happening.
Go right to hell.
They're really boring, and I think in this level, they make you do like four sets at once. Every hacking thing? It's really annoying and really bad and really dumb and really not fun.
That closer to a five is just not good video.
No, I don't even enjoy playing them. Like, maybe the mid-difficulty ones, yeah, but like this late in the game, they just become a giant pain in the ass.
They're fine. This game has like the least offensive hacking puzzles.
Oh yeah, they have the least offensive hacking puzzles, but they're still not fun to play.
It's fucking ball-bearing bullshit.
I can think of exactly one game where hacking didn't make me want to tear my eyelids off.
And that was Alien Isolation,
yes,
right?
Because it takes like 3 seconds. It's so... It's just match these and you're done. Varies them a little bit, but they all take, like, 3 seconds.
Man,
it's not
that's
just
some gropey sound loop.
Play this fucking minigame for 5 minutes. I hate that. I will stop playing the game because of that shit. I don't have time for this anymore. I'm an adult. I have a job. I have responsibilities. I'm not gonna play your fucking game for 5 minutes so that you can get your fucking rocks off. I'm mad about hacking games.
So, hey, tell me about Monster Hunter and its endless grinding.
That's all boss fights.
The same boss fights. Over and over again.
Over and over and over and over.
Nah, they do different things. Point is, that's the point of the game. This is shoot game, not hack game.
Listen, I'm a busy adult. I only have time to grind my game specifically designed for grinding.
I only have time to play the same game for 300 hours.
Play it, you know, for fun, man. I enjoy that game. I don't enjoy hacking.
Listen, I'm an adult. I don't have time for JRPGs anymore. I only have time to play 50,000 hours of Monster Hunter.
Thing is, I like the combat in Monster Hunter, not in fucking JRPGs.
That's fair. That is fair. If you can't enjoy the combat in a JRPG, it is very much a slog.
Now, I'm just rehashing arguments from every internet nerd ever.
Yeah, I know. Initiated the launch sequence.
If that thing gets I can't believe we're actually arguing over whether or not something I enjoy is a waste of time.
Anyway, we had to avoid slow missiles before we actually go fight the boss proper.
Ooh. Oh my god, there's a lot of them.
Nefarious. I'm saying nefarious.
Yeah.
He's right there. You can see him.
Good. That was great.
Yep.
Good game design.
You will pay for your insolence, you miserable rodent.
Actually, I'm pretty sure I'm a feline.
Sorry, Nefarious. Your flight's been canceled.
Don't forget to clean out your time litter.
Fuck.
Lawrence! Seriously, I don't have any features of a rodent. My front teeth don't grow.
Just
no.
Kidding. You've reached my holographic voicemail. Leave your name and a brief...
Oh, wait. This did the Archer thing, like, years before Archer was a thing.
That's a joke
yeah.
before...
Yeah, shut up.
I'm really sure that joke was invented when voicemail was invented.
Shut up.
Alright, so Nefarious is actually very pattern-based for this first segment. First he'll shoot a couple of, like, holographic clones at you, then he'll do this shit.
That's
I don't
cool
know
effect.
What this is supposed to be. Yeah, it's one of the few effects that Idlemind did not ruin.
No, he has evil versions of your guns. It's the evil machine gun.
And then he'll throw, like, little grenades that have shockwaves on them.
It's the evil bomb club or whatever.
Yep. And then he'll go back to throwing holograms at you. But yeah, that's basically this part of the boss fight. Once he gets down to, like, I think a fourth of his health, he'll start to run away.
Just not moving at all.
Yeah, are you going to use a weapon that does actual damage at some point, or...?
Yeah, I am. I just want to save my good weapons for later. Also, I realize I haven't shown off the shield glove. Here's the shield glove. It kind of sucks. And also, Idlemind's ruined the effect.
Wow! Wow! That looks so
That's
bad.
Amazing.
But yes, I was going to use better weapons. I just wanted to save my better weapons for the second part of the fight, so this way I don't have to run to the PDA every 5 seconds later on. Because the PDA kind of sucks, because even though it says... Oh, damn it.
I have no choice but to throw myself on your mercy.
Really?
Shoot him! That's right. You're an idiot! Shoot him!
Come on, Ratchet, if you ever never watched wrestling, they do this shit all the time.
Okay, the PDA sucks because even though it says you can buy... Even though it says you can buy every weapon's ammo, you can only really buy a couple of weapons' ammo. And only one at a time. The PDA really is awful. And in between phases here, he will shoot this giant fuck-off laser at you. And you also have to fight a bunch of mooks. It's not too bad.
Okay.
think I lost my co-commentators.
No, we still hear you, idiot.
Oh, good. Yeah, no.
Okay. I couldn't hear you guys for a while.
Yeah. Yeah, we're not doing a second take. I'm not doing a second take.
Nope, it's fine. Fuck it. We're doing it live.
So, what's your PDA do, Kalon?
I explained it already. I'm not explaining again. Fuck you.
This is a mess. I'm just... We're all very tired of Space Cat.
And to think I want to do another one of these games, because it looks good.
You can do that one on your own. I'm done with Space Cat forever.
No, you're doing more than another one, Kalon.
No.
No, you are. You totally are.
Yeah, I will probably be doing Space Cat for forever.
And I will probably be there with you.
Yeah.
And I will bitch the entire way.
Listen, all you have to do is just not play the fucking game, and then everything will be blind. And you'll be surprised. Don't play, like, half the game, and then get bored, and then quit, and then be like, yeah, I know what half the game's like. Anyway, no. Nefarious now has a couple new moves. He'll throw missiles at you, and then I completely fucked up jumping over that bomb thing because he's throwing them lower. And then he also will continue to do that giant fuck-off purple laser. As well as his other moves. He's less pattern-based now, but he'll still do all of the older moves.
Like, yeah, that's the idea of this whole boss, is he's supposed to have evil versions of your weapons, like, legitimately.
Yeah. It's pretty great, to be honest.
Yeah, it's a cool gimmick.
I think he also had evil versions of your weapons in A Crack in Time.
Yeah.
I'm so glad that I had the shield up, because I would have gotten wrecked there, because I'm pretty sure I just got hit by 4 shockwaves.
Yeah, you did. You're good at games, though. Yeah, totally.
This shit wrecked so hard.
I wonder if anyone's still watching this after that one little incident.
No. It's going to be interesting hearing your guys' audio for that. I was just quiet until I finally said, like, I think I lost my co-commentators.
No, we were riffing on you the whole time.
Oh, good. Good.
You fucking idiot.
Listen, I didn't fall off.
You fucking scorched your toes.
Burnt the tip of your tail. Their place smells like burnt fur now. It's awful.
Oh, God. Anyway, I am actually legitimately surprised that I did not have to go into the PDA to buy more ammo for this fight, because I had to do that like 12 times in practice run. It was awful.
Not exaggerating at all.
Yeah, those holograms, you know, look good. Not.
No. No, they don't look good at all.
I don't mind.
They seem to be at like 12 frames per second too, which is weird.
I appreciate the fact that there was a HD collection. I just wish they had gotten a better company to do it.
Like, apparently anybody else.
No, not the people who did Silent Hill. Also, the Rift Inducer is useless on him.
Mm-hmm.
Like, even at level 5, it does not shoot its little electricity out to hurt him, so, Well.
We need, like, one of those little things where they have at the Academy Awards shows and stuff, where if you talk too long, and I just a little wrap it up.
Oh, the small girl from the Ig Nobel Prizes. Yeah, I'm bored, stop talking.
I call it Base Odyssey.
Now, Lawrence!
Lawrence is pretty great.
If you insist.
He's only a mediocre bass player, though.
Yeah. Anyway, apparently the Bio-Obliterator is a Transformer.
Hmm. Oh, that's a...
He's Unicron.
He's a Pacific Rim.
Where did your eyes go?
So now we have to fight the Bio-Obliterator, and it's really easy, because all you need to do is circle strafe and serpentine at the same time, and there you go. That's the entire fight, right there. Of course I'm making you sit through all of it. Fuck you guys.
Serpent strafe.
1998 tactics.
Serpentine.
Drink your serpentine.
I was gonna say...
Damn it. I set in 5 box tops for this LP. Can't believe it.
To destroy the Bio-Obliterator, shoot it until it dies.
Okay, so I actually do want to talk about the new Doom because it looks great and I'm glad that Rip and Tear is a game mechanic.
But do my enemies have huge guts and can I rip
yes,
and tear
they do.
These guts?
Yes, they do!
No,
they do! You can totally...
Game of the year.
The trailer is pandering to the internet, that video.
Don't care, I'm easily pandered to.
Yeah, same here!
He said, thing I know about, I'm a Bahead.
Every fucking Ratchet and Clank trailer is pandering to Ratchet and Clank fans, and guess what? I'm eating that shit
Listen,
up.
Listen, every time I see a Doom trailer, I just think, I'd really want to play Serious Sam now.
Why is this cutscene in noticeably lower quality?
Because it was pre-rendered in the PS2.
Huh.
And also, despite being lower quality, the polygons don't clip right through it because it was all pre-rendered. They didn't bother redoing the pre-rendered shit, so it actually looks better.
Mm-hmm. Huh. Good job, Idle Minds.
It's been like that for all of them, and you're just noticing it in the final cutscene of the final game?
I usually don't pay attention. I've already seen them. I usually just, check my email or something while they're happening.
Oh, and this answers the question. Apparently, all of them are movies.
Christ.
Also, I'm pretty sure that is every unique model across the PlayStation 2 games that weren't villains. Oh god, what Bond movie is this ripping?
Die Another Day.
Yes. That one was bad.
Wait, no, there's several movies that had the skiing
scenes.
Yeah,
there's a lot of ski scenes.
Die Another Day is the first one I thought of, though.
The time has come. Yeah, I was specifically thinking of the Pierce Brosnan one, so...
Okay, then.
Yeah.
You fool, I am not weak to potassium.
But my eye was twitching, so thank you! Get this thing off me!
Oh my god, that was a Doom door sound!
Smooches!
Aw, you playboy. Not even think about it.
And that was Up Your Arsenal, which, unlike the last game, did not shit itself in the last quarter of the game. It was good for pretty much all of it, except for Quados.
No, it's a good game, flat out. Always good. None is bad. Fuck you, the seals are good. Better than Loop Desert.
I like the parts that weren't backtracking.
Yeah, that was the thing that they fixed a lot in the later games, was that there is noticeably less backtracking. I think you only had to backtrack once into the Nexus for a single gold bolt.
And the parts where K-Rod remembered what video editing was a thing, those were pretty good.
Anyway, I want to thank you two guys for sitting through this in my questionable editing decisions. I want to thank everybody at Insomniac Games who worked on this game for making it. Even the sore bit. I will give you the sore bit. Anyway, I want to thank everybody who watched and participated in Thread, as well as voted for our amazing ship. I'm sorry that there weren't more ship votes, but I just...
Fuck it.
Fuck it, whatever. I will be sure to make the most ugly ship possible for challenge mode videos, which you guys will get to vote for which level I have to replay.
Is sewer level an option?
No.
Ow.
No, Aquatos will not be an option. I'm going to put right there that a couple of the levels will not be an option.
Also, arena videos are coming.
Oh yeah, arena videos are coming. The original plan was to play...
Cards Against Humanity?
Ticket to Ride? No. The original plan was to play Ticket to Ride over them, but that fell through, so we're just going to be doing Cards Against Humanity again.
Or some other similar game.
Yeah.
Honestly.
Something like that.
Probably shouldn't do Cards Against Humanity twice.
Yeah. That's sort of why I wanted to do Ticket to Ride, because I didn't want to do Cards Against Humanity twice, but Cards Against Humanity is just way easier to get people for.
Yeah, it's fine to get people to lash and quips game on.
Yeah, we might do Quiplash.
Anyway.
I might have that, like, pop down on the bottom corner or something. Is there anything or anybody that you guys want to thank while the credits are rolling?
I want to thank alcohol.
You always want to thank alcohol. I'm pretty sure every LP you've been in, you have thanked alcohol.
No, I didn't.
Oh, yeah.
I thanked an awful one, probably, I think.
Yeah, you did. You definitely did.
Sorry, I don't remember that.
Thanks to alcohol.
Yeah. Well, also thanks to that game being awful.
Anyway, next, like we said earlier in the video, is going to be Batman Arkham Asylum, a game I have been wanting to do for about a year and a half.
Also for real this time.
Also for real this time, yes. This is not a long con. I have so much footage for Arkham Asylum sitting on my computer right now. It's ridiculous.
Also, Caleb's probably going to force me to read comic books for the first time, so... Look forward to me getting mad about nerd stuff, I guess.
That's all these videos are, is us getting mad at nerd things.
Yeah, exactly.
I thought these videos were about you getting mad at my editing decisions and how poor video games I am.
That's just been the last couple of them. And to be fair, I've been in kind of a bad mood.
Oh.
But seriously, remember when it took an entire LP for me to convince you to cut out the hacking sections?
Well, now you have to work on doing the backtracking.
Yeah.
Hey, at least I've learned not to try and drag you guys into 100% finishing roundup stuff. I get other people who want to do those.
Yeah, I've always been doing some. So,
I get a couple people who have played the game before or whatever, and get them to talk about the game and not anything that's happening on screen.
Hmm. Yeah. I look forward to being blind about video games again.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's right. You haven't played Arkham Asylum.
Nope.
You haven't played any of the Arkham games.
I haven't.
All right, I'll summarize for you. You're Batman, you beat up the mentally ill.
No. Remember, in the first game, it is Blackgate prisoners moved over to Arkham, so you're not beating up the mentally ill, you're beating up the poor.
Shut up, I don't care. Listen, all I know about that series is in Arkham City, there's probing damage and Batman gets progressively naked for something.
Same with all of the games.
Oh,
yeah.
Good. Okay.
You have basically, as the night goes on, you get more and more beat the hell up.
Yeah, well, you'll see
Your
eventually.
Your suit does not magically repair itself.
Yeah, it's pretty great. Oh god, especially in Arkham Knight, your suit gets really fucked up.
Yeah,
that's
great.
Yeah,
at the end of Arkham Knight, you look like crap. Thanks, USB headset audio driver.
You have to put in everybody who had anything to do with the game at all.
Ow. I don't remember being able to use USB headsets with this game. That's weird.
We have the online component.
Yep.
Which I guess Kayla's abandoned doing videos on.
I don't know. I never took my PS2 online.
Yeah, neither did I, but then again, I didn't have the ability to, I don't think, because we have always been mostly a wireless house, and I don't remember the PS2 having wireless capabilities.
Oh, yeah, but I'm going to have to post now, just after this update is posted, about the hacks they did to get online working in a functional way.
I'm afraid we're well out of range, sir. Perhaps if you had bothered to specify a destination.
When will we be in range?
Oh, I'm sure something will come along in, say, 5 or 10,000 years.
Nah, we'll retcon that so it happens in, like, 2.
In the meantime, enjoy these soothing bass sounds.
Now what?
I don't suppose you can play drums.
Yeah, form a supergroup.
Ha ha.